Alright everyone, welcome back to another video. I am Slips.
I'm Stash.
And you are watching Two Piece and a Biscuit.
Two Piece and a motherfucking biscuit, stepping our shit up, motherfuckers.
Yeah. I did a test video, I don't know if anybody saw it. It was a Slaughterhouse thing at my house last night because I finally got a laptop, we got a camera. We're able to use headphones now, so as you can see, Dave's got some headphones somewhere. You can't really see mine, I'm using earbuds, but...
Oh, you puss.
Yeah, I couldn't find those. I don't know what I did with them.
What the fuck?
I couldn't find them, so you're I grabbed these. These work good. They're skull candies. They're good headphones.
Oh, those are good.
Yeah, they're like 10 bucks, so... but yeah, so we're able to not have all that extra, you know, stuff on the side and the little center thing that Dave was always, you know,
pointing at. Yeah, but that was fun.
I mean, I'm sure I can find a way to, you know, get the thing in there. So hopefully.
I can still do it.
Yeah, so we got everything going. We're going to do, as you guys see by the title, we're doing Slaughterhouse Goodbye. We haven't done really Slaughterhouse together. Dave could have heard it, haven't heard it. Doesn't matter. We'll react to it either way. I like the song. I want to get some Slaughterhouse on the channel. So
even if I have heard it, I mean, it's been in passing.
Right.
So it's not something that I've listened to like a whole lot.
Right. It's a good kind of deep song. The only person who's not on this one, I will say ahead of time, is Royce. Because when they did this album, for whatever reason, he's the only person who doesn't have a voice or a verse. And they have a couple songs.
Really?
There's a couple songs that's where weird. Like Joe won't be on a song or Joe might not be, Joel might not be. Sometimes the song doesn't fit them and they don't want to, you know, whatever. Yeah, so we're going to hop into Slaughterhouse Goodbye. We got it's that actual music video here in front of us, so which is cool. We'll be able to see it. You guys will be able to see it good. So, without further ado, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe.
Hit us down in the comments. Let us know what other rap you want to hear. Yep. We want to do as much as we possibly can to get you guys into this shit. Yep. So, now that we stepped up our game a little bit.
Hopefully we can get some more people watching and enjoying our setup watching. A little bit more. So.
Hashtag you like our new shit. How about that?
Hashtag like our new shit.
Yeah, and next week's going to be even better.
Yeah.
Oh my God. Next week, I'm so fucking excited about next week.
Okay.
So let's go.
Jump into Slaughterhouse Goodbye.
We're doing some sad shit.
I could've sworn it was a dream, but in reality it hit me like a nightmare. Or at least that's how it seemed. I just got a grip on our relationship. We was ironing things out, started picking up steam. And when we didn't need it's when it all got heated. And we both said some things that we probably didn't mean. God intervened, guess what was at stake. But we left nothing over, he put more on the plate. She came home from the doctor with news I've been wanting. Said family was incoming, she pregnant, twins coming. But that's gotta be a lie. She sighed, couldn't stop the tears coming from my eyes. The birth control she on, for them it's suicide. As long as it's still inside, two of them wouldn't survive. Hard turn from memorable to cynical. Picturing clothes for what would have been identical. Similar outfits and similar names. My deceased kids, ultrasound in a frame. So I'm deprived of my chance to be a better dad. Staring at my twins that I never had. Shed a tear looking up in the sky.
So that was the first verse. It's a little bit more of a meaningful song, of course. I was trying to find something that wasn't so rappity-rappy that they have. I couldn't find one I could pick.
I wanted to hear some rappity.
I know. I'm sorry, Dave.
I don't like these fucking sound. They made me fucking cry.
I kept coming back to this song over and over again. But, you know, he said they're talking about his wife, you know, being pregnant and having twins, I guess. But he said the birth control she owns for them is suicide. You know, it's just going to kill the kids. So he's just talking, you know, all about that. I like the one line he said. He said we started ironing things out, started picking up steam. He threw a little two-piece at a biscuit there.
That was a little two-piece at a biscuit. You know, the more I hear Budden, the more I like him.
Budden's, like, that's how he raps all the time. It's just like that. That's why there's some songs on the album Budden won't be on because it doesn't fit his style of rap. Like, I don't mind him rapping,
but like generally as the way he is towards everybody else, not a fan. Like,
me either.
You can't come out and say that fucking M's last album was shit.
Right.
Like, just because he said some bullshit about you, you don't like it, you can't say that album was garbage.
Well, the one thing that got me on Budden, I mean, that's all of opinion, but the one thing that he said that I didn't like when it came to Eminem, he said that Eminem hadn't put out anything with any substance in the last 10 years. And I'm like, in the last 10 years, you had songs like Mockingbird, When I'm Gone, like Toy Soldier. I like Toy Soldiers might be older, but he had all those songs that had a story and a meaning to it. It's not like he was just, you know, M does a lot of the rappity rap, you know, with no meaning.
Well, I mean... I don't really think that anything he does is without meaning. Like, right. I mean, there's meaning behind everything he does. There's a reason he does what he does. Right,
exactly.
But
I think his point was just saying him just raps, like double, triple speed and just rapping whatever. But
so he's better than you and you're going to diss him for it?
Right.
Like, don't be a bitch about it.
Right.
Like, but as far as him, like, lyrically spitting, I mean, his shit's got, I mean... I kind of respect him as an artist,
mm-hmm.
you know, a little bit more after hearing a couple things. Because, I mean, like I said, I've heard some of this Slaughterhouse shit, but it's been in passing. I haven't heard this. I don't.
Pretty good song.
I'm not familiar with it.
But yeah, all the verses are kind of, you know, around that central theme. Sorry about the puppy. But yeah, and what's great now is we both can pause it. If you ever want to pause it, you hear something, just...
Goodbye, goodbye, so long, farewell, but it's not the end.
Okay, sorry. She's kind of hot.
Yeah, she's cute.
Not gonna lie.
She's cute.
But I'm not gonna lie. I mean, even with the blood out of her eyes.
Yeah.
Kind of cute.
So I assume the kind of symbolism of that she's like an angel of death type thing, you know, kind of seem like she's a black angel. But I'm just saying it's kind of symbolism in the video. Yeah, but we'll get back into Crooked's Get Ready to Start Going on them. So here we go.
Biological sperm donor didn't wanna be a daddy, so we hopped in his caddy and turned corners on us. Turned on us out the clear blue. His last memory of his son is seeing me through his rear view. I still love him, yo, but I love his brother Mo. My uncle showed me love no one can know. Young and poor with a tougher road to suffer. Hunger was nothing but uncle would hold us down, help moms lift the mother load.
Oh god.
I mean, he's just,
holy shit.
And his flows are just like, he's flowing like crazy, but like, you know, he's saying so much shit, you know, he's saying my biological sperm donor didn't want to be a daddy, so he hopped in the caddy and turned corners on us.
God, you man.
Know? And he said his last memory of seeing his son was seeing me through his rear view, like as he's leaving in the car, you know? And that's just, dope, you can imagine that, someone that's looking dope. Up in the rearview mirror and the son's behind him, but then he's just saying
I fucking love Crooked. Dude, like, Crooked. Have you heard the Crooked Snow song?
It's been a long time ago, but I've heard it like once or twice. We'll get to it.
We need to do
that. I just found out on my way here that Crooked and Joel Ortiz both have a whole album together with Slaughterhouse.
Really?
Just on my way here, I was like, look, I'm like, holy crap, this is a whole album. And I was like, listen to some songs on the way here. Yeah, some pretty dope stuff. But yeah, so I just like that right there. He said, when Unc will hold us down, help moms lift the mother load, you know, because
Dude.
I mean, he's just...
He's ridiculous.
Yeah, and he's dope. And I like the video's kind of cool, too, so I'll bring it back a few seconds here because we...
But I love his brother Mo. My uncle showed me love no one can know. Young and poor with a tougher road to suffer. Hunger was nothing but uncle would hold us down, help moms lift the mother load. I got grown in. I used to wonder what it would be like to speak to pops as a grown man. He provided that feeling, told me to take my career into my own hands. He was there when I had no fans. My cell phone rings, and after I answer, a voice says your uncle's been diagnosed with cancer. Worst news in my life, him and chemo going 12 rounds with a disease and they both losing the fight. I'm rushing up to see the sign, I'm praying for a miracle. I don't want to see my idol die before he did. The look in his eyes said, even though you just got here, goodbye.
She's got a great voice.
She's got a really good voice. I don't know who she is because I've never her name's not on the song. It's not on the
I don't know who she is, but she's pretty, and she's got an amazing voice.
I feel like I've heard her some other songs.
When she just did like the whole goodbye, farewell, but she hit that high note, dude, and that's dope, man. I mean,
I like to sing really good. And also, because like I said before,
stop barking at the TV.
When Royce was in the song, I think the reason, because his type of verse, I don't know if you've ever heard the song Tabernacle before by Royce. It's kind of about his son being born and his grandma dying. It's a whole story. But the way I think that whole song would kind of been his verse on this, and he kind of already had a song about it. So I think that's probably why he didn't put a verse on this, because he ended his song, well, even though you just got here goodbye, when he had that song. So I think that's why he didn't have a verse on this.
Gotcha.
We'll get back into it. But yeah, she's got a great voice. I don't know her name. If anyone knows her name, let me know, because I don't know who she is.
Yeah, this is up.
So.
out the corner of my eye, hoping you on the couch. That call felt like I was beef that got shot up. Ironic, I was on tour with Tech N9ne and Slaughterhouse. D tried to talk
to me. I like that bar there because he said that call felt like beef that got shot up. Ironic, I was on tour with Tech N9ne and Slaughterhouse. Said like beef because they're right. Slaughterhouse and Tech N9ne, like a tech, like a gun. Right. Nice bar.
Yeah, shout out.
I like when you have those bars that are still in a meaningful song. You still have a meaningful song, still spit a two piece in a biscuit. Moving on.
That got shot up. Ironic, I was on tour with Tech N9ne and Slaughterhouse. D tried to talk to me. Crystal rubbed my back as they was pouring out. I caught the next thing soaring out. Now I'm in the air in the Midwest somewhere. They said the turbulence was severe. I don't know what they talking about. I ain't feel a bump, body numb, mind drifting. I'm sniffing, asthma acting up. I'm whistling, I'm wishing. My mother face looks so much different. I'm kissing, I'm sun, my aunt pacing in the kitchen. My vision blurry, still I saw your face clear. What a loss. Time I did more than waste beer. Michelle Strong, she held on, we got all the way there. Then we walked in and she fell on the floor. This ain't fair. You was the voice when I considered them thoughts that ain't clear. Hey Granny, I was fifth row at the Grammys. An award they ain't hear me, but I sat behind Whelan, right in front of Wayne, and got seen by the family. I missed the early morning combos, believe me. Regis on the TV and the best baked TV, but you had an all white affair. Grandpa's all fly, even though you been got there. Goodbye.
I mean, Joel, I mean, I think that, you know, that was about, like, you know, his grandma and stuff. But, you know, I like the line there towards the end. He said, when he said he was at the Grammys, he said, hey, Granny, I was fifth row at the Grammys. He said, an award they didn't have, but I sat in front of Will. Yeah. Or sat in front of Will. Or
Lil Wayne in front
of
me.
Lil Wayne in front. Yeah, and got seen by the family, you know. So, overall, like I said, I mean, we still got all that. We'll let her finish out her singing. But
who's he related to?
Who, Joel Ortiz? Yeah. I don't know.
Is there somebody like big?
Maybe. I'm not aware of. He could be like, there's David Ortiz, but I don't know if he's related to the baseball player. He could be. He's a baseball player.
That's Big Poppy, bro.
Yeah.
Don't be speaking ill.
He could be related to David Ortiz.
He's my favorite.
Yeah. I like him.
That's my dude.
I don't know.
Sock.
Yeah. Oh, I know.
He's a sock.
Yeah. He's a sock.
He is a sock.
I know he is. But yeah, I've liked the song so far. I like all the verses. I just kind of want to get some Slaughterhouse on here, but I'm going to let her finish out her singing so we can listen to that. And that's the song. I like the song. So.
Yeah, that's good shit, man.
I mean, I definitely want to get some more rappity, like, you know, some more bars, heavy stuff.
I'm not big on the sad songs,
I just kept listening. I'm like, man, I keep coming back to this song when I keep thinking of songs to pick for it. I'm like, I like this song.
No, I get it. Like, I understand why you like it. Because it is a good depiction of everybody, even though...
Yeah, even though Royce wasn't on. But like I said, we'll have to do his Tabernacle song, whether you've heard it or not, and listen to it, because it's one of my favorite storytelling songs of his.
Yeah, okay. I'm down with that.
Telling a story of his life and stuff, kind of. It's a really cool story. But yeah, I mean, I like all the verses. I think Crooked's probably always been my first favorite verse in there, but I love them all. Like, Joe's verse is good, Joel's is good.
He's just dumb, dude. Like, Crooked's amazing.
He did, he's so good. But yeah, like I said, him and Joel Ortiz did a whole freaking album. It was like 2010. I saw it. I clicked on one song and saw that there was a whole album. I'm like, holy crap. I said, I'm going to have to pick through some songs on that eventually.
Yeah, we're going
to
have
to. But yeah, comment down below any more Crooked Eye, any of these guys, any Slaughterhouse songs.
Any of these guys individually or the entire group?
Yeah, the entire group.
These guys are dope, bro. Yeah. Like, I mean,
I got some
more. Who knows how to pick them, bro?
Yeah.
Let's say the goat knows how to pick them.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, he does.
Unfortunately, it's a basketball team, dude.
Yeah.
I mean,
unfortunately, you know, their group didn't get to, you know, do some more albums and things together because their albums didn't sell as good as they should have. But, you know, unfortunately, with big names like that, it's hard to believe that their group didn't, you know.
Right.
Because I would.
Well, it's not a
mainstream.
Raven, will you stop? Yeah, it's not something you can play on the radio. You know what I mean? That song probably was.
Yeah, that song,
but
song you could,
it's not something that's seen like, okay, let's put this right on the radio because everybody's gonna listen to it,
right?
Because it's not, you know what I mean? Like they want that poppy bullshit, they want that mumble crap, and these guys are spitting truth and they want to hear that on the radio.
And bars, and I mean they're probably four of the best lyricists, and you know, like all of them in one group is just insane.
Right.
But yeah, so hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. Hopefully you guys are liking our new setup. We got plenty more videos to come for you guys.
So looking forward to this.
Looking forward to this. This is awesome. It's great. I'm glad I got it.
I said funner.
It's more fun. More funner.
No, funner. Funner. That's my word. Funner. We're going to be funner.
We're so much funner.
Funner.
But yeah, so if you guys enjoyed, be sure to leave a like, comment down below what other songs we should do.
Hit us up down in the comments, guys. Let us know what else you want to hear. We'd love hearing from you guys.
And be sure to subscribe. And
what is it? Two pieces of biscuit?
Deuces.
Deuces.